here during the 23rd Olympiad. It's the weightlifting competition. 50 nations will be represented, and a record-setting 209 athletes will compete for the gold. You're looking down at the Albert Gersten Pavilion on the campus of Loyola Marymount University. This campus sits on a hill overlooking the coastline of Los Angeles. Hello, I'm Lynn Swan, and alongside me, my expert commentator for weightlifting, Bruce Wilhelm. Perhaps in no other event is the absence of the Eastern Bloc countries more heavily felt than in weightlifting. They hold 9 of the current 10 world records in this event. But the chief beneficiaries of their absence should be China, Japan, and the United States. So far, after 3 weightlifting events, the Chinese have 3 gold medals. And Bruce Wilhelm, I'm still looking for the Americans.
Well, the Americans are here, really they are, but we won't be seeing them until the last 3 nights of competition, the first heavyweight, the heavyweight, and the super heavyweight categories. In the first heavyweight, we have Ken Clark, who has an excellent shot at a bronze medal. That class is very tightly contested. The heavyweight class, Guy Carlton, should win a bronze medal without too much trouble. But the real story, of course, is in the super heavyweight class, where we have Mario Martinez, who has an excellent shot at winning a gold medal. It'll be tough competition, but he does have the first shot since 1956 for us to win a gold medal.
On Sunday in the first division, the flyweights, there was an upset. This young man from the People's Republic of China, Chen Kucheng, in his first attempt in the clean and jerk, lifted 130 kilograms, 286 and a half pounds, to win the first ever gold medal for the People's Republic of China in weightlifting. The next evening, the first American lifter to compete in these games was Albert Hood. It was his third and final attempt in the snatch for 112.5 kilograms, 248 pounds. This lift would be a new American record. This is the way Bruce Wilhelm and I called it that evening.
Oh, he seems like he's got it. Beautiful lift.
Albert Hood. Young man, he loves to break dance as a hobby. Cheered on by the American crowd here. Now a standing ovation for Albert Hood.
And he was hardly finished at that point. The American record for a two-lift total was set by Charles Vinci in 1960. Albert's first attempt at 130 kilograms, 286 and a half pounds, would finally break that 20-year-old mark. His two-lift total, 242.5 kilograms, 534 and a half pounds. Although Albert Hood only placed 8th in the bantamweight division, he made big steps towards a long future.
He's got a nice clean, cleans the weight well. Sudden dip, he has to ram it over his head. He's got it there, it's a tremendous effort by Al.
Judges signal for the weight to come down. 3 white lights flash, indicating by the 3 referees it is a good lift for Albert Hood.
But the winner of the bantamweight competition was Wu Shudei, again from the People's Republic of China. He was the favorite coming into the competition, and he lived up to his billing. In his third attempt in the clean and jerk, he lifted 147.5, 325 pounds. He jockeyed back and forth backstage, waiting until he had the last lift, then he went for the gold.
A lot of power, he's got the clean. He's jerked away. Look at this, this is the champion right here. Tremendous effort, 325 pounds.
Wu Shudei of China.
He's happy, no question about it.
He came into the competition as the favorite. He waited out his teammate, Lai Runming. Realized he needed a lift of 325 pounds.
Well, what an exciting conclusion, Lynn. Isn't that fantastic? Is he happy or what?
A standing ovation. They're calling him back out. They want him to come back out. And with a bow, he does. Wu Shudei wins the gold medal for China with a two-lift total of 267.5 kilograms.
And then last night in the featherweight class, Chen Wei Quang found California still rich in gold for the People's Republic of China. He sealed victory with his first attempt in the clean and jerk, the lift, 347 pounds. So after 3 days of competition, China has captured all 3 of the gold medals and 2 silver medals. Although China was expected to do well in the lighter weight division, no one dreamed that they would dominate the first 3 days so completely. Weightlifting is not exempt from its acrobatics and its moments of balance and grace. Looks like a dancer, Bruce.
Yeah, this is really pretty incredible. I like this one right here. He drops his bar and almost takes the referee out.
No one said making those calls was an easy job.
It's like Stagger Lee here. He's all over the platform waiting for the down signal. Didn't quite get it right. Great lift here.
Everyone is not successful. You try and you try, but sometimes the weight finds its way to the floor before you want it to.
This is incredible, the backflip this man did before the competition.
I'd give him a 9-9 on each one of those flips, but here, Bruce, he gets my 10.
This was really great. I like it when he gives himself a little tap on the noggin here. That's good.
There's his head, but his legs are still wobbling. And so, in spite of an occasional minor difficulty, these athletes will leave their failures behind them in an effort to make that good lift for Olympic glory.